Hello and welcome to Riding Highway. Today we will see some of the best settings for your GoPro Hero 7. How you can bring out best of your GoPro videos by just making some changes in your settings. So we'll start with the video. Before starting the video, if you are new to this channel, consider subscribing. If you have any query at the end of the video, please leave your comments in the comment section below.
Okay, so to start with the video settings, go to video settings, and you can see the first thing which we have to change and which we have to adjust according to a good video quality is resolutions. So resolutions, 1080 is considered HD, high definition, and that's generally the resolution I use because I'm happy with the quality and I'm not left with the extremely high file sizes like in 4K or 2.7K resolutions. Personally, my computer doesn't perform well with 4K footage because of the high file size. So choosing your GoPro resolution is a personal choice based on your preference, what you are trying to achieve with the your video, and what your computer or mobile device will be able to handle for you. Like 4K I use very rarely, or for some small clips. Otherwise, maximum I use is 2.7K with 24 or 60 frames per second. 60 frames because in case I want to add slow motion to my video while editing the clip in editing software. I recommend if you are brand new to using GoPro, start with 1080, 24 frames per second or 60 frames per second, it depends. Many times new GoPro owners find that their phone and their computers aren't up to the task of processing 4K footage, and they are left confused and frustrated with why they can't watch or edit their GoPro videos. Try out the different resolution. Like, you can try different resolution in your GoPro. Try the different resolutions and see what's going to work with you. And that is, like, it's a personal choice. If you have a good computer, good machine with the highly configuration in your system, then definitely you can shoot your videos in 4K or 2.7K. So the next after resolution, we have FOV. FOV stands for field of view. FOV setting will affect how much of scene your camera captures and will also affect how distorted your video will be. The GoPro has a wide angle lens which gives it a sort of fisheye effect, but you can reduce that effect by selecting linear mode. So this is the mode on which I shoot most of the time. Linear is a more flat look, more like what you would expect from video shot on your phone or basic DSLR camera. And next we have wide and super view also. So wide is, like, you can see here on the screen, this is the linear, this is the wide, and this is the super view. So in super view or in wide also, you can see there is a little fisheye effect which doesn't go with my rest of the clips, like from other cameras or from my phone. So I keep it on linear mode. This is the best from GoPro. It gives me the flat video clip. In the stabilization menu, you can toggle between auto and off if you want to keep it off, if you want to keep it on auto. The new hyper smooth stabilization on the Hero 7 Black is pretty amazing. I mean, it's really good, and I keep mine set to auto. If you like smooth footage, you will want to keep it set to auto as well. This is new Protune. You have to keep it on. Why? Because if you keep it on, you have more functions where you can actually make changes and you can get a better footage out of your GoPro. If I turn off, as you can see, I don't have any other option. But if I turn it on, I get these other options where I can actually make changes and I can get better video clips. To start with, shutter speed, I keep it at auto. EV comp, exposure value compensation. So I keep it -1.5 if I'm shooting in day, -0.5 in low light or night. So if you're shooting under these settings, you get perfect clip because your ISO compensate and will level your clip without lowering the quality of the video. We'll see ISO setting in some time. So for white balance, I keep it auto. ISO minimum is 100, maximum 800 during day, or 1600 if I'm shooting in night or low light. So that is the overall setting which I use while I'm using GoPro, it depends. I'm shooting outside, I'm shooting indoors, or I'm shooting during night or daytime. I can change my settings. I cannot use the same setting throughout the day. So always use Protune, always make changes, see where you can shoot. For the resolution, I've told you, you can shoot with 4K, obviously, but if your system doesn't support 4K and you'll like end up doing nothing with your video clip, doesn't make sense. So it's better start with the 1080p, and later you can upgrade to 2.7K. That is maximum. You'll get a very good video clip, and you can change between the frames per second FPS. You can shoot on 24. That is universal. If you shoot on 24 frames per second, you'll get a very good video, more realistic video. If you want to add slow motions while you are editing your clip in your computer, then definitely you can upgrade the FPS. You can go to 60 and 120, but please make sure when you're going to 120, you have stabilization on, or hyper smooth stabilization is available there with your resolution. So this is the setting. I think these settings will give you some idea how you can use your GoPro if you're new, or you have purchased a new GoPro in a recent time, or you're using for a while but you don't know like which settings are best for your GoPro. So I think try these settings, because these settings work for me, and I'm using it, and it's been quite long I am using these settings, and I have some very good video clips out of these. That is it for today. I think you like the video. If you like the video and you're new to this channel, consider subscribing. I'll see you in the next video with GoPro accessories. What are the accessories which you need, basic accessories which you need. So I'll see you in the next video. Till then, keep on creating awesome content.